Once upon a time in a field of corn, a farmer dreamt of a wife without a history of porn. So he packed up his silk shirts and fled to LA to separate his wife from the rolls and the hay. Met 25 girls and most of them were just fine, but others were crazy and liked to drink lots of wine. Dara and Jordan just had themselves to blame as they left with hangovers in a bachelor walk of shame. Shout out to Ashley, the craziest of them all. She loved her onions and she loved to crawl. Was she really wasted? Did she forget her meds? Either way, she wasn't quite all right in the head. Then there was Jillian and her two short shorts. She wasn't there for grace, she was just there to play sports. And I can't believe Mackenzie actually got a rose after calling Chris out for having a big nose.
Snow. You went home in tears, but baby girl, I have no fears because you'll be bachelorette and be
remembered for years. So we'll see you next season, picking guys for the right reasons. And if you don't do the show, well, you should come chill with me then. Hey, not offended, up with Prince Farming, but he frenched every girl. It was rather alarming. Soulmate still out there, but it wasn't Chris. But hey, now there's two girls left, but only room on the farm for one Southern Belle under Chris's sweaty arm. Whitney's ready for babies, cause she makes them every day. And Becca's still hoping that Chris will be her first lay. Both girls are so gorgeous, but if I had a choice, I'd pick Becca over Whitney, cause I can't stand her voice. But it's not up to me, it's up to Chris to choose their fate. Will he go home empty-handed, or find a soulmate?